The anticipation is mounting here as both sides get set for this matchup between the San Francisco 49ers and the Cincinnati Bengals here at Paul Brown Stadium. We got a crossover conference game about to kick off here. Any thoughts before kickoff, Phil?
Well, these two teams don't know each other very well. So when you don't know the other team real well, you know what happens? You get surprised. A lot of big plays. This will be fun to watch.
Brandon Tate with a chance to run back this kickoff. And that return ends rather quietly, short of the 20. Let's mark him at the 16.
Ohio!
The 49ers come out in a dime package. Ball's going to be incomplete. A hit knocked the ball out.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
Second down coming up. Johnson standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. The catch is made at the secondary. Touchdown, Eagles.
How about this get? A wide open receiver down the field. The quarterback, good job of finding. He throws it down there and he gets the easy touchdown.
Extra point is good. Bengals ready for action. And a flag comes out. Can you believe this? It was like what Carolina did in that Super Bowl 38 long ago after they had just tied it with about a minute to play and they kicked it out and set up the Patriots at the 40. You talk about just giving the team a huge break.
Well, it just turns the game completely around where you're thinking about, hey, we're going to stop them and get good field position. Instead, you kick it out of bounds and now you're just trying to hold on to get a chance to take the game into overtime.
Met at the 40-yard line.
That's his job right there. Most of the time, defensive tackles are not paid to sack the quarterback. They are paid to stop inside runs like that one.
Escaping the pressure. He steps out. Davis, usually a tight end, but he's in the backfield this time. Colin Kaepernick from the shotgun. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Bolden hauls in that bullet throw.
What a nice catch by the receiver. Getting past the yard markers, makes the catch and gets a first down.
Setting up in the pistol on this play. They give it to the back, and he's running off tackle.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
Kaepernick's back in shotgun formation. That catch will extend the drive.
You know, when you throw the football like that down the field, you pick up a first down, now you can do anything you want on the offensive side, and you got that defense guessing.
Was a big gainer. Now it's time to pack it up. Gore's got it now on the draw.
How about the defensive line? Getting that penetration, getting off the football at the snap, and getting it done, getting in the backfield and making that tackle.
Second and 13. Running away from the pressure. He's looking to the right. San Francisco, touchdown.
Well, here we are. It's a tie game now. We'll see how the teams react to it.
Will it be positive or negative?
The 49ers with the PAT to come. Got a flag, and the extra point is good.
Running into the kicker. Defense.
Running into the kicker. 49ers setting up for the kickoff. Always a threat, and he'll start his return now. First down here. Drop back, shotgun formation. Getting sacked.
Well, that's a sign of a good defense. When you can sack the quarterback when you're just rushing the defensive lineman, you don't need any tricks, you don't need any blitzes. Man, that's talent.
Second and 22. The throw to the left. And almost picked off.
That's a nice route that time by the wide receiver. Running the corner route, and the quarterback just throws it too far and misses it.
The pass play fails to work. And now it's third down. Of course, it's a three and out.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense that time.
Green's got the cool hands on a pass that had a lot of heat.
Yeah, I'm sure you're really proud of yourself that time. You go for it on fourth down, you get it. I'll give you that, but I still think it was a bad decision.
That reception gave them the first down. The wide receiver in motion. Trying to work that left side. Could have been intercepted.
This is frustrating for a coach. You call a play, you get the receiver down the field on a corner route, and your quarterback cannot put it on the target.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Second and 10. They'll run it. Here's the handoff. Fights through that hit. Reed is there and makes the play.
An off-tackle run. It's a staple of all offenses in the NFL. And a general rule is you run off the right tackle because he is the power tackle, where the left tackle is the pass blocker.
Here comes the wide receiver in motion. They need to get the playoff. He'll throw it over the middle, right where it had to be.
Well, Jim, I always say it's about deception when you're playing offense. That time, the play action fake by the quarterback was so good, the defense didn't even see that he still had the football, and he throws it down there for a nice completion.
First and 10. They run the counter play, and they knock him down just a yard away from the first.
When you have a defense as fast as this one, they over-pursue. So that's why you want to run a counter run. Take advantage of the fact that they are just charging too fast, too hard, and not thinking on the defensive side.
Second and one. Slashes to the left side, tossing it to the running back.
Well, the defensive coach is going to be upset after this play. After that long run, terrible angles, and really just a lack of hustle by the defense gives up the long run.
First down here after the run.
Here we go.
Out of the shotgun, looks to his left. The Bengals are in the end zone for the touchdown.
What a tremendous throw by the quarterback that time for the touchdown. What confidence he has in that arm. Small window, very little room to throw that football in there. He didn't worry about it, fired it, got the touchdown.
The 49ers in kickoff return formation. Got a chance to return this one.
Ohio. Watch the blitz.
They come to the line, and it's first down. Johnson's got it in the gun. He'll fire it out to the left. Makes the tackle after a pickup of 15.
That time the pass is completed into double coverage, Jim, but the quarterback made a bad read. But these receivers, they are so good nowadays. That time in double coverage, he went up and made the catch. It's like Bill Parcells said to me once about Mark Bavaro, a very talented receiver. He goes, remember, Sims, when he's covered, he's open.
The second quarter is underway with this snap. And incomplete. Coming up, second down. And he's going to pitch it here. Touchdown, Bengals.
Well, that was a good job on that touchdown that time, and I'll tell you, there's nothing like being on top of the other team and make them chase you.
The Bengals with an extra point try on the way. And it's a fake. Got the touchdown. Got the two-point conversion. People love to go for two in this game, don't they?
Well, they do, and you know what? Now I guess you and I just can't sit here and blast the coach for a bad decision. When you pick up the 2 points, you can't complain about what they're trying to do.
Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. Baldwin's in the slot. First and 10. Looking across the middle, had it for a moment, but the ball is knocked out incomplete.
Good job that time, Jim, by the defender. He hit that receiver so hard, that football came flying out. That's why it's incomplete, the big hit by the defender.
This will be second down. Little screen set up here. He had no time to get set. The defense comes out of the dime. It'll be a third and 10. Looking for an open receiver on the right. The 49ers now move the chains.
The quarterbacks and receivers in this NFL now are so good. It's so easy for them to throw and catch and just keep picking up those first downs.
Ohio!
Colin Kaepernick,
Ohio.
Under center. Down, throwing again. Looking for a receiver on the left side here.
You got to be agile as you make these kind of catches. One of these short drag routes across the field. That time we saw the agility of the receiver. Nice catch.
Second and 7. He's looking long. And they can't connect. Outstanding coverage on the deep throw, forcing the incompletion.
That's why he's one of the best in the league. He's aggressive. He can take away short passes, but also has the speed and the ability to get back there and knock down those deep ones too.
Davis playing out of position in the backfield here. Third and seven. Going across the middle. Challenges the coverage and has the completion.
You just can't expect your defensive backs to cover that long. It's good coverage initially, but the quarterback had all day long, and sooner or later, these great wide receivers are going to get open.
The 49ers lined up in the pistol. What a hit, and the ball falls incomplete.
You might as well catch it, because you're going to take the big hit no matter what. That time, the receiver lets the ball go because he was worried about the defender making the hit.
They're loaded up in the full house formation. Second and 10, looking to the right side and throwing. Kaepernick hits Crabtree with that pass.
Well, I think we've heard this expression about 7,000 times. It's a passing league, so we all know that. So you got to be able to throw the football and pick up some first downs.
And a good gainer. Let's give him 9.
Anytime you get in the red zone, you want to punch it in there and get 7 points. They're being dominated today. They're down more than 7, but don't worry about it. Score here and just keep playing.
Second down coming up. The quarterback will hand it off.
Terrible call that time by the coach. The defense was expecting run. They were up there. They were aggressive, crowd the line of scrimmage, and you just played right into their hands, and they got the tackle for the loss.
For 14.
Well, anytime you're in the red zone, you want to punch it in and get that touchdown. If they do that, look, they're still going to be behind, but it gives them confidence moving forward.
First and 10. Looking to scramble. Throws to the right. Just had to avoid the sack. Incomplete.
Jim, that was really a terrific job by the quarterback. The pocket is breaking down. And look at that. He just steps up, moves out. Good job of keeping the play alive.
Play number 12 coming up for the offense. On second and 10. To the ground here. They bring him to the turf.
This is where on the defensive side, where you have the lead, the team's driving against you, call something different so you can come up with a big play and stop the offense.
Mounting a serious drive. They feed him the ball again. Gains 5.
Oh, my gosh. He should have scored that time. Gets tackled inside the 5-yard line. Now we'll see if the offense is good enough to push it in.
First and goal on first down. And he breaks the plane. He breaks the plane. He's in for the touchdown.
I'd say this run by the offense is just, it's arrogance. They just say, you can't stop us. And they lined up and just shoved it down the defense's throat. Nice run there on first and goal for the touchdown.
Makes the PAT. The Bengals are ready to return the kick. He's got a chance to return this one. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. Offense lines up here. The formation here, shotgun. But they can't connect.
In the NFL, you got to throw the football deep down the field. But the quarterback just, he overthrows it.
Second down. Easy catch there. No one near him.
Sometimes they tell the receivers just to go long, run a fly route, run a 9 route, because that means straight ahead, or a streak. Show the speed that you have and get it done.
And we've reached the 2-minute warning in this one. First down following the long play.
loads it up. It's going deep.
And it's incomplete.
Well, you must, on the offensive side, throw the football deep three or four times a game. That time, they're just not able to connect on the deep throw.
Offense lines up here.
Second and 10.
Challenging the defenders to the right side.
Quarterbacks love play-action passes because the defense, sometimes they're expecting run. You fake it, easy completion down the field.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. The 49ers are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here. The Bengals come out in a two tight end set. First and 10. They're running the option. Here's the pitch. Nowhere else to go, and he's out of bounds. You talk about controlling the flow of the game. Another first down, and the drive keeps on going.
Yeah, why not? The defense, they're just sitting over there. They're taking the hits and not even fighting back. It's a terrible job by the defense.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. First and 10.
And it's incomplete.
Terrible throw by the quarterback. Terrible route by the wide receiver. Oh, wow, what a shock. The football was incomplete.
They bring in the extra tight end. Second down and 10. For the score in the end zone.
What a tough throw and catch into a tight spot right there for the touchdown. But today's game, these players are so good that you have to throw it in traffic. They've got to make the catch. That time he did.
In trouble now. He's looking to the right here on this throw. They failed to convert on the two-point try, so they'll just have to settle for the six. Bengals ready for action. Waves his arm, and he's going to make a fair catch. Gore's lined up in a single back formation. They send the tight end in motion. First and 10, and the give to Frank Gore. Picks up 9.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Second and 1. Quarterback gets the ball back from the halfback. Flea flicker all the way.
Tipped away.
Oh, good job by the linebacker knocking that pass down that time. All he did was watch the eyes of the quarterback, and he reacted. It put him in good position, and he knocks the football down.
Baldwin's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Frank, the ball is jarred loose. They recover their own fumble. Just when you thought they may have a costly turnover, they're able to somehow recover the football.
You know, Jim, you know what happens to guys on offense when they fumble the football? You know where they go? To the bench. That's where this man is going. You fumble it, you're in trouble, you take him out of the game.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. From the gun. He's going deep. Newman with the interception.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
first down as they head to the line. Johnson's going to take the snap from the shotgun.
Airing it out.
Able to get a step on the defender, and he makes the catch.
For so many years, we had all these rinky-dink, dink and dunk quarterbacks. Now we got guys in there throwing it deep down the field. What a nice catch. What a really good deep throw.
First and 10. As they go ground here, he's in the clear, and he'll step out of bounds.
Boy, after watching that long run, I'm winded. That was a nice job by the running back. Good job up front, sustaining the blocks. Offense got to be happy with that.
New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground. Johnson's going to take it from the gun. Justin Smith brings the quarterback down. The Bengals signal for the timeout, and they have none remaining.
Ohio! Ohio!
And now they'll try over again on second down. The quarterback motions the wide receiver. He'll fire it out to the left.
Ball's picked off.
Well, nowadays, your linebackers, they got to be able to do everything. They got to be big enough to get in there and stop the run, and also athletic enough to be able to get in position and make an interception. Good job by the linebacker.
Baldwin's a receiver in the slot. First and 10.
Backed up on the offensive side, the quarterback's got to be extremely